few moments that we have left, we want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.
How do you go about tightening your belt? I'm going to help you guys. Some people should know this. I mean, if you can't, people that are working and young folks that are working, give you a couple keys. Like, one key is you should have some type of emergency money. I don't care, married, separated, single, divorce, whatever. You personally should have some type of emergency fund money. Shit can go wrong. Just have an emergency fund set where you can't touch it. Say you need tires, say your brakes go out, say the kids need some clothes, or say something happens. Just set aside maybe anywhere between $1,000 to $5,000. Now, you don't have to have $5,000. I'm just saying, slide it in and out. Secondly, now this is a rule of thumb I was taught. My parents taught me this. Try to, if you can, I know it's hard and it's calming. Try to save up 6 months worth of all your bills in a bank. I mean, it's easier said than done, trust me. I know it's true. Save up 6 months worth of bills in the bank. Put it in a separate account. Don't mix with the money you're spending now. Next, cut out non-essential bullshit items. You really have to go to McDonald's every fucking day? You really need to go to Speedway to get a coffee every fucking day? You really have to go to lunch at Eaton Park every day? Do you really have to go to IHOP every Saturday because you want to? Can you afford it? Stuff like that. Also, pray for a rich relative to die. I'm fucking with you on that one. Fucking with you. Don't pray for a rich relative to die. No emails, please. Another situation is, don't lend money you're not willing to lose. I was taught this as a young child, and I still practice this. If I lend somebody some money, I'm good, and if they don't pay me back, well, then I just charge that off as that's how much it took me to get them out of my life. Do I want the money? Yes, I want the money. But let's face it, not everybody's going to pay you back. There's other routes to getting your money. I like being in front of this camera right now. I don't like to be detained elsewhere. So I just hope it helps you out a little. Get out of this financial crunch that some of you may be in, going to be in. But like I said, it could happen to me. I could be on welfare tomorrow for all I know. My job is not guaranteed. I might be the new poor. Like I said, I have been through it. I'm not gonna lie to you. I haven't been on welfare. Whatever days I was eating rice every day, literally every day. Every day grilled chicken. I was living it. So when cats, like I said, but at the end of the day though, we come from the bottom. Like we come from the bottom. So we're used to it. So whether I'm on top or I'm on the bottom, still the same me. Money never made me and money will never break me. That's what I'm trying to tell you. But other people can't live like that. There's people that can't tell their kids no. Look, if your kid really needs something, that's one thing. But if you just bond just to shut the kid up, you gotta cut that out. That's how it is. This is the new economy. So, all I'm saying is, cut your spending. All I'm saying is, there's gonna be a time where you may be laid off. You may have to be the new poor. Don't think that not everybody on welfare is a welfare bum. Like if you just sitting back here collecting checks just to collect them over years, decades, you a fucking welfare bum. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. But if you trying to better yourself, use it as a crutch, well then, you know how it is. So I'm out. I gotta go. So peace.